Greetings, Roxie Guitar Army. How are you doing today? Are you ready to learn an Alice Cooper song? Because I'm ready to teach one for you. And this is a good one. This is one off the Eyes of Alice Cooper album. Came out in 2004. I had the pleasure of co-writing it with the band, along with Alice Cooper, sitting in a room in the valley, in the 818, as we would say, up at Eric Dover's house. And we just came up with this song. Coop came in and said, hey, I'm feeling like I'm the man of the year. So let's write a song about it. And I had sort of a punk rockish sort of guitar riff that went around with that. And that was what it was sort of a nod to. A nod to like 70s punk rock, Sex Pistols a little bit. But also, this song proves that Alice Cooper is some sort of wizard. Because in the lyrics, he actually predicts that he plays golf with the president. Before he had ever played golf with the president. Now he has that story in his belt. Weird, huh? So, man of the year. What do we have to do to learn this song? We have to be in tune. So the first thing we'll do to kick off this song is tune. Because I always say tuning is the most important part of your playing. Because if you're going to play wrong notes, they better be in tune, right? So if you don't have a tuner at home, you can check the links below, above, sideways, wherever we are. We have a play along tuning series that we have up. You can click right on it. And you want to tune to a half step down tuning. That means your E string is going to sound something like this. And when you play a big old E chord, it's going to sound something like this. So why did I pick this song, Man of the Year? It's because you, Roxie Guitar Army, spoke and I listened. You wanted songs that you could get under your belt within one of these quick one-on-one lessons and be playing it by next week. And I definitely think you can with this song because all you really need to study for this song are your fifth string bar chords and your sixth string bar chords. Know the names of them because there are a couple sharps and flats notes, but for the most part, it's all bar chords. There's a tiny bit of a punk rock type note solo, but that's easy and you can get that under your belt. I'll carry that over near the end of the lesson for those of you that want to learn that little solo break. But for the most part, it's all your power chords. So why don't we start with the intro of Man of the Year? Just to begin with, there is going to be a notey solo, which I'll go over after the chords. But the chords to begin with, you start with your fifth string, bar chord, power chord, E, then C sharp, B, all fifth string bar chords. Then you go to your fifth string open sort of power A, sixth string big open E, back to our fifth string power chord, B. So that whole intro that you will find is kind of slowy for us to begin with. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And now you'll notice your right hand is going to be doing a lot of downstroke picking. So that's a cool thing about this song too, because a lot of punk rock and Ramones-y type songs are all downstrokes when you're doing the rhythm. So again, with that intro. And then we start with the verse. I always talk about economy of your chords, right? So you don't want to be playing a chord here and then have to go way up here to play the next chord. You try to want to keep it in the same area of the guitar neck. So with your fifth string and sixth string power chord knowledge, I want you to play the verse, which will be B to G, F sharp, back to B. That, my friend, is the whole verse. But I'll play it sort of in rhythm now. This is the first verse. One, two, three, four. Get ready to change. F sharp. B. sharp B. That is your first verse and your second verse. So you're going to be pretty happy with those. A lot of songs have a pre-chorus. This one goes right into the chorus, which happens to be just like the intro. So if I was to take this song this far from the intro all the way up through the first verse, going into the first chorus, it would sound something like this. From the top. One, two, three, four. First verse. F sharp, B. Here comes the chorus. See how easy that first chorus was? Play it just like you did the intro. That will lead us on to the second verse, which we will learn now. We don't even really have to go through it because you kind of know it. When we do the playback, you'll hear that the first verse and the second verse are exactly the same, but it's exactly the same pattern. You're going to go do the B, fifth string bar chord B, to your sixth string G, F sharp, back to B. This would be the second chorus. Play one half more. Cut that, because when I say play one half more, we will be going into our, I guess you would call it pre-solo, right before the solo. So it's like you could call it a little bit of a bridge in a song, because when I'm teaching these songs, I want you to learn song structure as well. So that second half of the second chorus goes like. So what is this bridge, this note thing? Well, it's basically A to G. Three times. Then this note. So what is that note riff? That note riff is a pentatonic type lick that you're going to start on the fourth string, ninth fret, and go down to the 7th fret, so. Then you do the same thing on the 5th string. Slide down to the 5th fret. Going to the 6th string, 7th fret. Then 6th string, 5th fret. To the 2nd fret on the 6th string. So. And of course your right hand has to do that wonka wonk. One, two, three, four. So this would be the entire bridge part. A to G. Remember? One, two, three, four. Right now. And then the solo. Well, you're in luck if you're playing rhythm guitar on this song, because the solo is just a B pumping with your right hand and those eighth notes. Got that part as well. So you got all this rhythm chord structure is on your what? Fifth string bar chords and sixth string bar chords. That's why I stress so much when I do my lessons. You got to know where those fifth string and sixth string power chords are all over the neck and know the names of them. So you're pumping on that B during the solo, and you get into the breakdown verse. Breakdown verse is no different than the other verses. You just hit big, long power chords. So, last verse. Then go to the bridge. Then we have an Eric Singer signature flam on the snare drum, and we will hit the last verse. Last verse, same as all the other verses. This is the last verse. To the last chorus. Different. So I just played that last verse and chorus out in almost real time so you could understand what it is. The only difference that I did in the last chorus was play a little bit of an octave. So that last chorus that's an octave goes like this. So when I do an octave, basically I'm just hitting the root note. Instead of hitting its fifth, I just hit the string underneath it. So if you want to think of it as my Sharona. Maybe you don't want to think of my Sharona. I'm not sure. Maybe you don't even know what my Sharona is. So that's even better. But that last sort of chorus goes right into the bridge A to G section with the note riff ending on the. Okay? That should do it for all your rhythm parts on the song. Now, for those of you that want to dip your toe deeper into the soloing aspect of this song, let's dive into that solo, shall we? We'll have a little note solo, and it's not a hard one either. It's just more legato notes that we're playing. So we'll start with the intro solo, okay? So basically, and again, this is gonna be more of the same note. This is a cool little thing that Alice Cooper Band members throughout history have done. This sort of hitting a note and then bending up to its to the same octave note, or not even an octave note, to its same note. And we will start this with your first finger, second string on the ninth fret, and then you take your third finger, put it on the 11th fret, but bend that third finger up to the note of your first. So watch. You can hear the ghost of Glenn Buxton channeling through me right now, going. And every other 70s guitar player too, because we love this stuff. So once you've gotten that technique under your belt, we'll start with this note, which is the first finger on your ninth fret again, and bending your third finger on the 11th fret up to that note. That is actually a, I guess it would be a G sharp or A flat note, right? That's the whole entire solo to the intro, okay? So one more time. Go right into the first verse. Now, let's get under our belt the very, very downstrokey guitar solo that is in Man of the Year. So, I'll take it from the bridge, which is the first A to G part. And that little riff is, got your third finger on the D note, which is second string, third fret, and then your second string, your finger, is going to bend up on that third string, bend up on that second fret. Then let it go down, and drop it down to your first finger on the first fret of the third string. So again, I'll do it real slowly so you can zero in on my left hand and see what I'm playing. One, two, three, four. Let's repeat that. So when you get all those guitar parts going together, that's why you'll figure out real quick why Alice Cooper has three guitar players. Because when we start doing the rhythm part, this part, and then you have this third part. It's a little higher part. Check it out. So this third part is, again, starting on the 10th fret, second string. You bend that up, and you play just the second string and the open first string. It's a little bit of a octave thing to this one. So when you get those two going together, try either of them or just play those old chunky B chords along with the playback, and you'll be part of this sort of, I guess, what would you say, wall of sound. And that's sort of the point of this song too, is to sort of hit you like a match truck at a live show. So you have gotten all the parts down to Alice Cooper's Man of the Year. I hope you enjoyed it. We're ready for the playback. And before we do the playback, I just want to get your feedback, how you guys are feeling about these lessons. If you want me to continue doing them, please leave your comments and your feedback below or above or wherever you want to do, or just send me some sort of message to keep on doing this. Because at the end of the day, the whole idea is to get more of you to start getting a guitar in your hands and understanding and realizing that you can do this, all right? You got this, man. And that's why I will do the best I can to pass the torch of rock and roll on to you in future lessons and keep on working on my methodology of teaching guitar in a quick and sort of easy to digest manner. Hopefully this song helped with that. Again, fifth string power chords, sixth string power chords. I cannot stress that enough. So are you ready for the playback? I know I am. Let's do it. Okay, so I'm going to do two run-throughs right now. The first one, I'm going to do just all of the rhythm parts, just all of the chunky fifth string and sixth string bar chords. And then the second run-through, I'm going to do obviously the chords as well, but I'll do it with the solo parts in there. So you have two versions to work with. Enjoy both.
The wine, my heart forgets. I pet the dogs and It was the greatest funeral I laid in perfect state. Later I will meet the Lord. I bet it just can't wait to meet the man of the year. I'm the man of the year.
You might have noticed one thing. If you want to ruin your guitar picks, which I love to do, if you have enough of them lying around, you can do that old pick scratch down. There's a ton of them. And all you do is you basically just scratch that pick right down the fifth or sixth string, your swing string of choice. And you can have a lot of fun with that, and a lot of fun, I guess, ruining guitar picks. So let's go for that second run through, shall we? So I'm proud of you. You did it. You got it under your belt. Keep rewinding. Play it a few more times. And then do something really, really novel. Go out and play it in front of people. You know, you can be the best guitar player in your own room or your son's room where you record these things. But the true test is getting out there and playing it in front of people. And you know what? You might fall flat on your face the first couple times. I know I have. I know I've done that. And you know what? At least once a tour, I fall flat on my face at least on one solo or one song per tour, at least. But the idea is you got to go out there and do it and perform and show people you know how to play this thing. And it's you have it. All right? So until next time, You know how to get in touch with me, RyanRoxie.com. Keep spreading the word, Roxie Guitar Army. Let's keep building it up. Let's keep doing these things. Let's keep building this sort of movement of people playing guitar. That's what it's all about. You know it, I know it, and get in front of people, all right? I'm always approachable, except maybe on stage when I'm doing my thing, and hopefully you're getting into that as well as I do my thing. Hope to see you out on the road, and I don't know. Like I always say, enjoy the ride.